Hello student, welcome back. In the last period we have seen that what is acid rain and what is the the effects of this acid rain. We have also seen about the organic acids, okay, and we have seen that how this acid rain formed and how this acid rain is harmful for the marble buildings, okay, and which is also called as marble cancer, okay. And then now later on we also saw that the different properties of acids, okay, when acid reacts with metal, what happens? When acid reacts with carbonates, acid reacts with bases, okay. So these are the reactions that we have seen in the last period, if you remember, okay. Reaction with alkali means bases hota hai, okay. Alkali, in the last period I have told you alkali means strong bases, okay. So that we have seen in the last period. Now see, let us recapitulate this chemical. These are the chemical properties. These are all first, second, third. These are the chemical properties when reaction of acids with bases. These are all the reaction of acids with these different things. Like when acid reacts with metal, they form salt and hydrogen gas. Example, we have seen in the last period, if you remember. Then when acid reacts with carbonates, acid plus carbonate forms salt, carbon dioxide, and water. These are the three products. And when acid reacts with alkalis, they form salt and water, okay. When acid reacts with alkali, they form salt and water. So this salt formation can be different salt formation in the reaction with acids can be tested by using the universal indicator solution. There is a indicator called universal indicator which can be used to check the formation of different types of salts here, okay. Now let us go to the next point, that is neutralization. Hope if remember that what is neutralization. See, in this reaction NaOH and HCl, this is hydrochloric, this is hydrochloric acid, and this is sodium hydroxide, okay. Sodium hydroxide and hydrochloric acid. Now when hydrochloric acid, which is a strong base, strong acid, this is strong acid and strong base, okay. When these two combines together to form a H2 and NaCl, and if you measure the pH of these two, they are totally neutral product, okay, neutral product. So as these two neutral products are formed here, the reaction is called as neutralization reaction. You can see the base pH 12 and pH of acid is 2, and when mixed together, the acidic and basic solution produces a more neutral solution. Actually this is strong acid and this is strong base, and hence the product form is neutral, neither acidic nor basic. So it's a double displacement reaction. Reason is that why it is called double displacement, you can see here. So very simple to understand why it is double displacement, because here now H plus was there and there is a Cl minus, okay, H plus and Cl minus, here Na plus and OH minus. So H has reacted, H plus reacts with OH minus and Cl reacts with Na plus. So it is ion exchange method, it is double displacement reaction. And hence this neutralization reaction is also one of the type of double displacement reaction, acid plus base. And you can see here how it has taken place. Now see, this is the acid molecule, HCl molecule. You can see the animation, and to understand this, okay, this is the acid molecule, this is a base molecule, okay. Now acid, now this hydrogen is indicated with blue color. Hydrogen is indicated with, this is hydrogen, this is chlorine molecule, this is Na, and this is oxygen, this is hydrogen. Now if you see this, after the this hydrogen has gone from here, that is from now you can see here. Then from here OH, So this hydrogen and this OH has formed H2O, and this Na and this Cl will form NaCl. So this is a double displacement reaction. So very simple to understand. Okay. Now reaction with metals. Now what happens when acid react with metals? Okay. So when acid reacts with metal. Okay. Now actually this is the reaction between the base and metals. Okay, not acids. We have seen already acids and metal. They form hydrogen gas and salt. Salt along with hydrogen gas. Now this is a base. Now for example, we have NaOH plus we take metal zinc. Okay, the salt formation here, the salt formed here Na2ZnO2, Na2ZnO2. This is the salt formed here. Okay, I'll write it properly here in this way. Okay. The product is Na2ZnO2. This is called sodium zincate salt. What? Now this base react with metal. Base react. All the metal doesn't react with the base. Few metals react with the base, and this is one of the example that sodium hydroxide will react with zinc Zn. So that forms Na2ZnO2. That is a salt along with a hydrogen gas. H2 is also released here. Hydrogen gas is also released here. Okay, so now see, this is first chemical property of base. Now we are talking about the chemical properties of bases. Okay, now see, next chemical properties, reaction of acid bases with non-metallic oxides. When acid reacts with non-metallic oxides to produce a salt and water, see, acid if reacts with acid, like for example HCl reacts with non-metallic oxide, like CO2 is non-metallic oxide. CO2 is non-metallic oxide. When reacts with non-metallic oxide, it forms salt and water. So here what will form? H2CO, no, not H2CO3, it will form the product will be acid reacts with non-metallic oxides to produce salt and water. Okay, like for example here one example we are having, that is CuO, that is copper oxide. You know, copper oxide is a metal oxide, and when react with HCl it forms CuCl2 and H2. Okay, CuCl2 and H2O. Then we have next reaction, that is reaction with alkalis. When acid reacts with alkalis, it produces salt and water only. Okay, that is again neutralization reaction. As we already seen, acid reacts with base, or whether base reacts with acid, it forms salt and water. That is the neutralization reaction. Okay, now let us go to the next point. So these are all the reactions of acids with bases. Okay, so let us go to the next point. All the metals do not react with the base to form salts and hydrogen gas. Very important thing that you remember always, that all the metals do not react with base to form a salts and hydrogen gas. So the reaction takes place on the basis of reactivity series here. Okay, now if you remember reactivity series, I've told you already in 9th standard only. Reactivity series is the vertical column of the metals, by which we can understand that which metal is more reactive than whom. Okay, so this is the reactivity series. For potassium is the most reactive metal. After that sodium is less than potassium, then calcium is less than sodium, magnesium is less than calcium, aluminium is less than magnesium, then zinc is less than aluminium, chromium is less than zinc. Okay, so this is the reactivity series by which we can understand that the reactivity of the metal. So for displacement reaction to carry out, this reactivity series is very very important. Okay, because in displacement reaction, high reactive element can displace the less reactive element. So for this purpose, we must know that if the reaction is given, we must know that whether this metal is high reactive or less reactive, then only we can carry out the reaction. So this order of the metals you should know so that you can carry out the reaction of these metals. So see here, the reactivity series is given, and then here their nature of reaction is given. Now you can see that potassium and sodium, they are highly reactive. So it is mentioned here, react violently in cold water. If cold water is also there, they can react very, very violently. Rapid reaction takes place, very fast reaction takes place. That is the meaning of violent reaction. Then you can see here, calcium reacts slowly with the cold water. It reacts with the cold water, but not that violently. It reacts normally, slowly with the cold water. Then we have a next group of metals like magnesium, aluminium, zinc, and chromium. Okay, so these are the another group of metal which reacts slowly with the steam, but quite rapidly in the higher H plus concentration. H plus concentration means acidic medium may they reacts rapidly, but they react very slowly with the steam. Steam means the water vapors. When they are heated, cold water they cannot react. Okay, these magnesium, aluminium, zinc, and chromium, they cannot react with the cold water. We have to produce the steams by heating. So heat is required, then only these metals can react with water. Then we have a next group of elements, that is metals like iron, nickel, tin, and lead. Iron, nickel, tin, and lead. So for them we require reacts moderately high H plus ion concentration. React in moderately high H plus concentration means their reaction is not rapid, moderately high H plus ion concentration may they react. Okay, that not the reaction is not that faster. Okay, then we have another group of metals like copper, mercury, silver, platinum, and gold. Okay, so these do not react with H plus ions. Means in acid solution, if you add them, for example, I'll give you one example here. See, H plus HCl plus, I'll take Cu from here. Okay, Cu, copper. So here there is no reaction. Reason kya hai? Because H plus is less reactive than hydrogen. Cu is less reactive than hydrogen, and that reaction is not possible. So displacement doesn't take place here. So this copper is being less reactive, will not able to displace the hydrogen from the acid. So no reaction will take place. Then if you take anyone from this Fe, like from this group, okay, from this group, if you take anyone, write one more example. For example, I have a HCl and I have added Fe. So Fe is more reactive than hydrogen, so it will carry out the displacement reaction. So here the product will be FeCl2 plus hydrogen gas. Okay, so this will be the product. So reaction will take place, means Fe, iron, nickel, tin, and lead, they will all able to displace the hydrogen, but lower, that is copper, mercury, gold, silver, and platinum, will not able to displace the your H plus from acid. So this displacement reaction possible, where it is possible, where it is not possible, we can understand by the help of this reactivity series. Okay, so you can see here weak bases. What is written here below? Weak bases: ammonia, potassium carbonate, sodium carbonate, organic amines, and these are the examples of weak bases. Weak bases means which are not completely soluble in water. Okay, then we have a strong bases: sodium hydroxide, sodium phosphate, barium hydroxide, calcium hydroxide. These are all strong bases because they dissolve in water completely and they form the alkalis, that is strong base, okay, in the water. Then we have another classification of the on the basis of uses and their examples. Okay, so now there are few acids and then we are going to see them. Like H2SO4, we have a H2SO4 which is also called as sulfuric acid, used in car batteries, removes rust from the iron and steel. Now these are the uses. We must keep these uses in mind because for 2 marks 3 marks these uses can be asked in the exam. Many exams these questions are repeated, so you must know the use of each of these acid. Hydrochloric acid removes the rust from the iron and steel. Rusty, this corroded irons can be cleaned by using the hydrochloric acid. Then we have a vinegar, that is acetic acid, used in the vinegar to preserve the food. Acetic acid is mainly used to preserve the food. Then we have nitric acid, used in production of fertilizers. Okay, for the production of fertilizers like nitratic fertilizers, okay, that we say na, chemical fertilizers. For production of chemical fertilizers, we use the nitric acid. Then we have a few bases also here. Then the bases like calcium hydroxide, we have calcium hydroxide used in the neutralization of excess acid in soil. Okay, now see, when soil is more acidic, okay, when soil becomes acidic by the overuse of chemical fertilizers, that time we use the slaked lime in the soil. Slaked lime in the form of fertilizers we use so that the soil gets neutralized. Then we have a magnesium hydroxide used in antacids and toothpaste. Antacid means when we suffer from acidity, we use the antacid tablets. So in that antacid tablets, magnesium hydroxide, that is also called as milk of magnesia, is used, as well as in toothpaste this magnesium hydroxide is used. Then we have a NaOH, that is also called as strong base or caustic soda, that is sodium hydroxide, that is used in making soaps and detergents. Okay, soaps and detergents ko banane ke liye bhi NaOH ka use karte. Okay, then we have a few salts here, ammonium chloride in torch batteries. Okay, then ammonium nitrate in fertilizers. Okay, these are all salts, they are not acids and bases now. These are all salts: ammonium chloride NH4Cl, ammonium nitrate NH4NO3. Okay, then calcium chloride, iron sulfate, magnesium sulfate, silver bromide, sodium chloride, na? So these are the different salts and these are the uses. Okay, we have seen that ammonium nitrate used in the fertilizers, calcium chloride drying agent, you know, many different places when we buy the electronics, in that small packets are kept, they are used to absorb the moisture. So these calcium chloride as a drying agent also can be used because it absorbs the moisture, so it keeps the things dry. Iron sulfate in iron tablets, okay, as a source of iron for the body, these iron tablets are used. Okay, then magnesium sulfate, if you see in making medicines, this magnesium sulfate is used. Okay, silver bromide in photography, this silver bromide is used. Then we have a sodium chloride making NaOH, that is sodium hydroxide. Okay, we use it. So these are the different uses of salts and acid bases and salts. Now we see that acid bases and salts, when acid react with, now this is actually a very summarized points. Okay, which is simple to understand. Now see, when acid reacts with metals, you can see here, metal plus acid, salt and hydrogen gas. Zinc plus, that is example is given, zinc is metal, H2SO4. When zinc reacts with H2SO4, it forms zinc sulfate, that is a salt and hydrogen gas. So when any acid react with any metal, it always form any that respective salt and the hydrogen gas. On the other hand, when base reacts with the metal, then it forms again salt and hydrogen gas. Now you can see here sodium hydroxide plus zinc, Na2ZnO2. Actually, it has become O3 here, but it is O2. Na2ZnO2, that is sodium zincate. The name of this compound is sodium zincate along with hydrogen gas. Okay, then we have another reaction of acids and bases and salts with metals, carbonate. Okay, when it reacts with metal carbonate, you can see metal carbonate plus acid, it forms salt, carbon dioxide and hydrogen, water, H2O form hota hai yahan par. Okay, kya hota hai, when acid react with metal carbonate, it react it forms salt, carbon dioxide and water as a main products. Then metal hydrogen carbonate, when react with acid, that also form the same product, that is salts, carbon dioxide and water. Okay, now here example is mentioned that when NaHCO3 reacts with HCl, it forms NaCl, CO2 and H2O. So this is the next point. Now let us go to the next. When acids reacts with metallic oxides, when acid reacts with metallic oxide, instead of hydrogen gas, it forms now water. So this is how when acid reacts with metallic oxide, we have one example is mentioned here, that is copper oxide when react with HCl, that is hydrochloric acid, forms copper chloride plus water. Then when acid and bases react, that forms the salt and water. So that is again, now see here, non-metallic oxide reacts with bases. So you can see that what happens, copper oxide plus HCl, it forms CuC. It's not non-metal, there is a by mistakenly this point has come here, it's not a non-metal oxide. Now this is the mistake here, okay? So just it's a metal oxide plus base, it forms the salt and water. Non-metal oxide, it's not non-metal, it is a metal oxide plus base. It's not non-metal, it should be only metal oxide plus base, then it forms the salt and water. Now see here, acids, now here kind of mind maps are given, acids on reacting with metal oxides, when acids react with metal oxide, now let us see what happens. It forms the salt. When acid comes in contact of metallic oxide, it forms salts along with water. It forms salt along with water. So when acid react with metallic oxide, when acid reacts with metallic oxide, it forms the salt and water. Now when acid react with metal, acid react with metals. Now you can see here, the product is salt and hydrogen gas. When acid react with metal, it forms salt and hydrogen gas. Two products are formed here. When acid react with metal carbonate, metallic carbonate, that forms the salt, carbon dioxide and water. Salt, carbon dioxide and water. Now when acid reacts with base, it forms salt and water. So you could understand that how these acid, bases and salts react with these different products, like metal oxides. When they react with metal oxide, when they react with metal, when they react with metal carbonates, and when they react with base. Okay, so this is how the reaction take place. Now see, when acid is added to water, acid to water it gets diluted, and not water to acid, it splash. Now this is an important warning we must keep in mind. This is a very important warning that we have to add acid to water, not water to acid. We have to take more quantity of water and we have to add drop by drop acid in this water, so that whatever heat produced, because acid and water reaction is highly exothermic. So to avoid the danger or avoid the accident, we have to add drop by drop acid in water. Okay, more water we have to take and we have to add acid from the top. And while adding the acid, we have to add drop by drop, and while adding, we have to stir the solution so that that particular utensil will not splash. Okay, then we have next point, that is we have base. Okay, reaction of base with non-metallic oxide, you can see what are the products. Salt is the only product and water. Okay, when a base react with the metal, it forms salts along with hydrogen gas. Then we have acids with base, it forms salt and water. So bases are soluble in water is called as alkalis. Bases, such bases which are completely soluble in water, they are called alkalis. Okay, so that we have already studied in the previous parts. Okay, so let us go to the next point, that is base and non-metal oxides, acids and metals. Okay, so what are the common product? Salt is the common product in all the cases. Okay, so salt formation takes place. Okay, so this is the bases soluble in water are called as alkalis. This is the important line we should remember. Okay, so we'll stop here and we'll continue next video.